Buffered iodine 125 will then be added. The samples will then be allowed to incubate for 3 hours. The tubes will then be emptied of all contents. This gamma counter will measure the radiation from the tubes. That light that just blinked is now registering background radiation. The friends of the Washington Park Zoo bought us this gamma counter, and we use it to monitor the progesterone levels on a day-to-day basis. The tubes are then loaded into the gamma counter. A rise in the progesterone level usually occurs 2 days after ovulation, and at that point we know when to stop inseminating. The sample is then tested. This is a control showing little radiation. This sample has lots of radiation. The exact amount will correlate directly with the amount of progesterone that is in the serum sample. This is what a normal cycle of progesterone would look like. This particular cow averages ovulation about every 14 weeks. This is the progesterone pattern of a pregnant elephant. A comparison of the two. The lower cycle shows that ovulation occurred at about the 14th week. On the upper one, we notice that about the 11th week, the progesterone levels remain high, indicating that the animal is pregnant. Yearly graphs are kept on all our cows. Each cow is checked with a colonoscope to make sure that there are no physical abnormalities in the urogenital tract that would prevent pregnancy. The colonoscope has also been used for insemination. Here is the view from the colonoscope going up into the urogenital tract. We will be going up into that right-hand opening that the pointer is now on. Getting stuck against the mucosa. Semen that has been injected. Going back down the urogenital tract. That little flap is fairly common. Time of ovulation, we see a lot of mucus. Here in the center of the screen, we see a mucus strand.